What's up, YouTube? How's it going, Spill? What's up, Weekenders? So, last night I went and saw Rango from Nickelodeon, and animated by the good people at ILM. From what I understand, it's their first full feature-length animated film. And I gotta say, if they keep this up, Pixar, you guys, you got some serious competition. ILM and Nickelodeon, you guys, you're upping your game, and I'm happy to see that. I absolutely adored Rango. Rango was one of those, it was a nice surprise, because I kind of went into it not knowing a whole lot. Like, I just kind of caught glimpses from the trailer, and it didn't really, you know, explain a whole lot to me, and I didn't have a whole lot of expectations for the movie. I thought it looked really good from the trailer, and it is gorgeous. I mean, the detail of the animation in this movie is something that I'm still kind of shocked by how detailed and just how amazingly individual each one of these characters have. They all have their own individual looks and their own kind of mannerisms, and it's just, it blew me away while I was watching it, seeing all these people. And of course, Rango, voiced by Johnny Depp, is probably got one of the coolest character designs I've seen in quite some time. I just was blown away, I mean, by the animation. So let's get into the actual story. The movie opens with Rango in a terrarium, putting on a play with his toys and things that he has, or whatever he's got in his terrarium. He's the only animal in the terrarium, so he lives a really sheltered life. And he's putting on this play about him being a hero and all this, and I assume that, you know, they're going across country because something dramatic happens and he ends up getting tossed out of the car and the terrarium breaks and he's out in the desert, you know.
You're funny looking.
You're funny looking too.
That's a funny looking shirt.
It's a funny looking dress.
You got funny looking eyes.
You got a funny looking face.
Strangers don't last long here.
The lizard? He is going to die.
When is he going to die?
Soon, compadre.
So he comes across this armadillo who's trying to cross to the other side of the highway. And they have some words of wisdom, and the armadillo, whose whole goal in life is just to get to the other side of the road. You know, that's his, you know, the old saying goes, the grass is greener on the other side. I guess he's living by that. And he points Rango in the direction of the nearest town. So Rango ends up going into this town, and lo and behold, we end up in, like, you know, 19th century western town. You know, like the 1880s kind of version of a town. Or probably be more like a ass end of the 19th century, kind of just the beginning of the 20th century kind of western town, in that same vein of like the Wild Bunch kind of era, where like they're just starting to move out of this kind of western society into a more modern time. The mayor has a big role to play in this, and of course Rango comes in and immediately starts putting on an act about how he's the baddest mofo ever to kind of come into the town, and he's, you know, he killed 7 guys with 1 bullet, you know, stories like that. And through a series of unfortunate events, he ends up accidentally kind of winning the praise of the townspeople by accidentally killing a hawk, who I guess would be like one of their bigger kind of gunslingers. And that's actually one of the things I really enjoyed about Rango, was the fact that there were, You've got all these different kind of villains who show up. You know, there's a small gang of a posse of guys who one of his first confrontations in the town, as well as this hawk. You've got these moles who are essentially bank robbers that he has to deal with, and then of course towards the end of the movie, Rattlesnake Jack, who's voiced very well by Bill Nye. Well, not Bill Nye. Bill Nye is a science guy. What is it? Bill Nighy? Nighy? Yeah. Bill Nye is a science guy. Bill Nighy is the British badass. I have British subscribers. I'm sure they'll correct me if I said his name wrong, but I believe it's Bill Nighy. But yeah, he's in the movie, essentially playing Lee Vance Cleef's Angel Eyes character, if you will. Kind of badass, you know, never misses a shot, can hit anything. And he takes great offense to Rango because, you know, he looks at Rango as just this imposter, and he's the real gunslinger, and how dare this person kind of taint the name of gunslinging. Rattlesnake Jack essentially exiles Rango from the movie, which is important because, you know, in any good hero story, the hero has to kind of get banished and rediscover himself before he can come back and save the day kind of situation. That's a basic plot synopsis. I'm not going to go into any more detail.
Now, we ride.
That means we're riding now. This moment.
Like John Wayne, John Ford westerns, you might not be as big or a fan of Rango as if you're like if you love the Man with No Name trilogy or the Wild Bunch or Once Upon a Time in the West. You know, these kind of westerns that are really kind of build off of this ideal of like broken people and lost souls and guys who are looking for redemption and salvation. Or just trying to find their place in a world that's ever-changing. Like, my biggest beef with Rango might just be its predictability factor. Because if you watch a lot of Westerns like I do, I'm a huge Western fan. Particularly Sergio Leone and Sam Peckinpah's work, you know, those guys. Really influenced me when I was younger. You're probably going to be able to predict what's going on, and like, you know, it's pretty easy getting into the whole thing, kind of going, oh, I know exactly who's the ringleader here, and it's flawed in that sense, but in terms of it being a great representation of Westerns and a kind of celebration of Western films and plots, I think it does a great job. You know, it does a great job of molding all these things and putting little, you know, nuances and touches and in jokes in, and you know, like I said, if you're somebody like myself who watches a lot of Westerns, you might be able to spot more a lot of the kind of jokes and references a little bit better. My only other kind of biggest concern or criticism, I should say, with the movie, it does kind of reach this point. I'll say probably about midway, where you get this feeling like they didn't know what to do for like a little bit of time, like they were just kind of wasting time before Rattlesnake Jake appears and does his thing. And there's this kind of a dogfight essentially with bats that kind of goes on, and it gets to the point to where like these bats are actually blowing up as they're hitting things, which is, you know, kind of odd. I didn't really, that kind of stuff didn't really jive with me too much. But Gore Verbinski, he's got another winner on his hands. I mean, it's not a perfect movie by any stretch of the imagination, but it's certainly a fun movie. It's a movie that I had a great time watching, and yeah, he does great adventure film. Other things I guess people probably should be concerned with if you're going into this movie, it's probably not good for little kids, like little kids. It's not like Finding Nemo. It's not like one of those movies, because there's a lot of death in the movie. There's a lot of characters who get killed, because it is a representation of the Wild West. And while there's no like blood or anything like that, there are moments when, like I said, bats are blowing up when they're hitting the side of canyons, and there's a lot of gunplay, and so, like, you know, maybe not the best movie to take your 5-6-year-old to. But, like, for me, if I was 13 again, this is exactly the kind of movie I would love to go see. And I would probably see it multiple times, you know, as a kid. So it's definitely a movie I think young boys are going to love. I don't know so much about the young girls, but young boys, you guys are gonna dig the hell out of this movie. Anybody who loves westerns, particularly spaghetti westerns, you're probably gonna enjoy this movie a lot. And anybody who really is a big fan of like the art of animation, I think you're gonna really dig this movie just for its style and its character designs. So it's winning on all those levels. And if I had to give it a rating, a spill rating, I'd say it's probably an enthusiastic full price. It's worth paying the whole price for admission and checking out. And it's in glorious 2D, none of this 3D animation bullshit. It's in glorious 2D, so you don't have to worry about paying the extra ticket price, you know. It is, it's beautiful, it's in 2D, and it looks great in 2D. This has been my review for Rango for Spill.com. Hope you guys enjoyed. Check it out if you have not seen it.